Welcome CBS fires Nick Cannon, citing anti-Semitic podcast remarks. The network said that Cannon had promoted, quote, hateful speech during a recent episode of Cannon's Glass. In the podcast, he discussed conspiracy theories about Jewish people and praised a minister notorious for anti-Jewish comments. A Viacom CBS spokesperson said in a statement that the company categorically denounced all forms of anti-Semitism, however I want to pronounce that word.
I think black people can't forget that they can also be racist, and that you can also be a tool of oppression to another type of people. I think it's very easy for Americans to think for a second, black Americans to think for a second, that they're the only one with the history, and it's sensitive for other people. I've noticed this insensitivity towards the Jewish culture and history, especially what happened with them and the Germans and all that type of stuff. I think it's a bit sad. I think it's still a very big deal. And though that they have done better with healing in comparison to the black community, you still can't rubbish the pain. I don't think that there's any space for that. But
let's talk about the conversation, which is basically about, at least one of the things I saw that they talked about was that they have controlling power in the media, and they kind of use that power to direct what the narrative is about and how they handle it. And I mean, I'm sorry if this will not sit nice with someone, but it feels like that is exactly what Viacom is doing right now, especially with the fact that this seems like it's from his statements that he shared on Facebook. It seems like this is a ploy to satisfy the person with the higher sharing or the controlling share in the company, and this person is Jewish. So Fox also picked something off what he said, and they agree that it is wrong and how he said it. And they had a conversation, and they say that they understand and he needs to do some learning, and he has apologized and agreed that what he said definitely hurt some people and he would do better and learn better about that. So why is it such a big deal for Viacom to understand and maybe have a conversation with him, even at the point of agreeing that he has apologized on social media? I don't want to believe that he will come on social media to apologize and not apologize in the boardroom or in the conversation. So this is becoming when you want to kill somebody for pouring away water from a glass cup. That's how I feel about this particular one.
I think apology is not enough for something. Just because you are sorry, deeply sorry, does not mean that you don't bear the consequences.
So everybody that has said anything remotely racist or remotely anti-Semitism has to lose their job, has to lose everything.
I think it's based on discretion.
For us to understand it.
I think it's based on discretion for that person. But to act like being chastised for racism is an overstretch.
It's not just about racism right now. Maybe you need to read the whole back and forth that have happened on this case. If you're quiet, I don't know why.
No, because I'm just listening to you guys, because I also share the train of thought that this is way beyond what he said, because basically what he said can be said to be systematic racism, which a lot of us are guilty of, whether we know it or not. Sometimes systematic racism are just those things that you're just biased, there's just prejudice over certain people, certain thoughts, certain traditions, certain all of that. So it's something that we're all guilty of. So I think it's something that can be forgivable or slightly punished, not completely firing the guy. Especially like you said, I think they should have had a word with him if he does it again. But I think this is like, he's had series of cases though, things that he said, not just racist comments, like things that he said that has caused a lot of controversy. Even the monogamy thing is still being dragged to today, and then this comes up and all of that. So it's not the same. I'm saying it's that series of controversies. I'm not relating it to this. I'm saying it's that series and all of this.
No, but if you are bringing that in, then you're trying to say that they're looking at his history of controversies.
I believe so. Because I'm wondering the only reason why you would punish a man for systematic racism so deep, if not because you're putting into consideration all the other things he
maybe
has
done. Maybe other things, but I don't think the monogamy one will be part of it. Not every attraction or noise or backlash is bad for the company, and I don't think that was something that was bad. It wasn't offensive. People have a disagreement to his taste, but it's not an offensive or a derogatory statement. He didn't rubbish the female gender or anything like that. I don't really listen to Nick, so I don't know if it's anything else. I haven't really heard anything else. But maybe there's more things, but I don't know how I can feel comfortable saying that he didn't deserve to be fired, when if the tables were turned and it was a white person and they fired them, I would be very satisfied with that. So personally, I don't think I can take that stance as to say that it is a dramatic stance, because we do that with a lot of other things when the tables are turned for other races. So,
well, I like that you said it's a personal thing, and I mean, I wouldn't be calling for the firing of a white person because they said something that at the end of the day they probably understand and come out to say, oh, I'm sorry, I did not know that it will be this way. I mean, we need to create room for educating people and making them understand. We don't all know it. I'm sure that myself sitting down here, I've probably said some things, I've hurt someone in a certain type of way. We cannot be the know it and know it all, because we are supposed to represent
certain
people.
It's a different
people.
Thing if he came out,
if he came out to say, I'm standing on
it,
and that's what I think about them, then it's a different thing. Anyway, let's not
do
so
when you
much
say subtly and then all of a sudden it's...
And it was even a conversation with someone who felt that he has also been blacklisted by this group of people in the industry. So like you first said, it was a conversation on systematic racism and systematic whatever it is they want to look at it on. So it wasn't just about this person or that person. It's something that goes on in the industry, and which is why I'm saying, if they are taking this stance now, that they are basically showing, and even if you read the story, you realize that the media is deliberately making you understand that this is something that is probably made to favor the lady with the controlling share in the company, who is Jewish. So you are basically playing to the gallery. That's what I feel about it. But anyway.